Hi everybody, it's Patty, Rockstar Mom. Welcome to my channel.
Mama! Mom! Mom!
What, Biscuit?
May I please say something?
I'm filming, Biscuit. Wait a minute.
I know, Mom, but it's very important.
Make it quick, okay?
Mama, I promise I'll be short. That's funny. I am short. I have these little bitty short legs. Okay, here's to all of our friends here on the YouTube. My mama has been reading me all of your sweet messages to her last video. And I know it would just be horribulous to be locked up while my mama makes one of her videos. I would be so sad, and I would cry if she did that. She's a good mom, and I know she loves me very much. So I promised her that I will try my very, very best to be good from now on when her camera is rolling. Just remember, everybody, I love you. You love me. We're a great big family. Over to you, Mom.
Oh, my goodness. I'm afraid now that he may want to make another appearance in this video, so I don't know, we'll just have to wait and see. But what I'm really afraid of is he's going to want to start and be in all of my videos, and that's just not going to happen. So this is a get ready with me, obviously, and it is going to be entirely drugstore makeup, and all of it I think you can purchase at your local Walmart or one of your drugstores, except for a couple of items. One item you can only get online. It's relatively new. I searched and searched and searched, couldn't find it locally, so I had to order it online, and I will tell you about that when we get to it. The other item is not drugstore, and I will explain all about that when I get to that too. So we're just gonna get some makeup on. I am going to use, and you saw this recently, I'm trying to use it up, my Milani cream to powder foundation. And you can see I have really hit pan in this. And oh, by the way, this, I say, always try to remember to say this, but this is not a tutorial, so don't tell me I'm doing something wrong. This is the way I do it. And for me, it's always changing, always changing. As we age, I've said this before, and I know those of you who are close to me in age already know this, but our skin, there's just a point when we start changing, and our skin starts changing. Sometimes it seems like almost daily it's changing. And so what works today may not work tomorrow. You know what I mean? Have you experienced that yet? I tell you. And then again, it might work next week. So I don't know. I'm using a brush, and it's not necessarily a brush that I always use. This is a Sigma brush. It's a round Kabuki F82. It was clean. That's why I chose this one. It's real thick bristled. That's what I like for foundations. Real thick bristled. And I like the way it applies my foundation. Okay. By the way, speaking of foundation, I have had, in the last video we talked about maybe doing a Foundation Friday, and so many of you said that you would like that. But in thinking about it and looking at what I have, right now I have things that I've been using a lot and you've been seeing a lot in videos recently. Whoops. So, let me hold on. Is that better? I didn't have a light turned on. So, I'm going to hold off on starting Foundation Friday. And when I start to buy new foundations, because I've hit pan or run out, or I found something that I just don't like out of my stash, and I have very little in my stash now foundation-wise. So I'm going to wait until I start to get new foundations, and then I'll do Foundation Friday. We'll try to do something with these non-existent eyebrows. I have tails, but the hair is white. I've said this before. I've never had to pluck my brows. This is the e.l.f. Instant Lift Brow Pencil, and this is the color Bronze. And this is the color Blonde. I was using Taupe for a long time, but I've sort of switched over to the Blonde, and I think I like it better. Although, it doesn't show up so well on those tails, but Blonde. Oh, and by the way, the Milani, I know some of you are going to ask about that. It is 07 Medium Beige. Typically in all foundations, I use a medium beige if they have it. That just seems to be my color. If I'm darker from the sun, I can sort of warm it up with bronzers usually. So, okay. The next thing I'm going to do are do some tight lining. And this is a NYX pencil. And it is in the color Sunrise Blue. Let's see if we can do that. And I'm going to pull my eyelid up and get under there. I find that the higher I can raise my eyelid, the easier it is. And it just makes my eyelashes look a lot longer. I wore blue eyeliner forever. I mean, for as long as I can remember, until I started my YouTube channel, and I sort of branched out, but I love blue eyeliner. I used to tell my daughter back in the day that when I died, if she did not make sure I had blue eyeliner on, I would come back and haunt her. I'm not going to be buried. There's not going to be a funeral, so we don't have to worry about that anymore. But I still do like my blue eyeliner. Okay, the product I was telling you about for eyeshadow, I'm going to use the CoverGirl Trumped Cream Eyeshadow. It's the cream eyeshadow stick, and I've got the Mogul Magnet and the Unruly Indiscipline. It has an apostrophe. And I think I am going to do the Unruly Discipline. It's sort of a purpley color. And I'm just gonna go over my lid with it. This eye for me is drooping more than the other eye. It always has. And so I sort of have to adjust it. I get some really good suggestions from you guys on things that might work for me, and I always appreciate that. But truth be known, I probably already tried it. Someone said in a recent video that I shouldn't, if I would put a lighter color on my lid, that it would open, I think you said it would open my eye up more. And you're probably right about that. I do that from time to time, but honestly, I like my eyes dark. Okay, we may play around with that just a little bit more. I'm going to go back in with my blue eyeliner and just go on the outer corner. As I've said before, I can no longer do any kind of a wing or a flick. Well, I could, but because I have a fold there from my eyelid, it makes it jagged looking. Now, I told you that there was something that was not drugstore, and it is my mascara. And the reason I did not include a drugstore mascara is I don't own one, and I didn't want to go out and buy one to use just for this when I still had mascara left that I need to use up. And look at this, my mirror is off again. There we go. So, let's see here. This is Lancome. It's called Big Monsieur Big. This was the Ulta birthday present, at least at my Ulta store. And I like it. There are others that I like too. I use L'Oreal Voluminous, I guess Black is Black, forever. I sure wish L'Oreal were cruelty free. I don't understand it. I know all about China. But if CoverGirl can get around it, I would think L'Oreal could too. Oh well. Okay. Let's do some blush, and I am going to use this. Oh gosh, it's dirty. The Profusion blush kit. I got this at Walmart, and let me clean that off for you. I'm going to use, I think, Delight, this color right here. Let's see what that does. And this is a, I don't know what this brush is. Something's Pro Sculptor, but I don't know who it's by. Ooh. That and then I'm going to go ahead and use the blue NYX eyeliner, the same that I tight lined with, and do underneath. You know, you guys, y'all are just the best. I mean, when I mentioned at the first of the last video about Biscuit and the one complaint that I had, it never occurred to me that almost every single one of you would talk about it, would mention it, and tell me how much you liked Biscuit and you liked seeing Biscuit. That made me feel really good. And obviously, it made Biscuit feel good. All right. E.L.F. Concealer, and this is the 16-hour Camo in Light Sand. And I am going to just try to use my foundation brush here. Also, in that last video, I talked to you about the skin cosmetics. That Dimitri James on HSN, the Divine Elixir, and a couple of you told me that it was sold out. And I was on HSN yesterday, I believe, and he was on again. I'm gonna go a different color here on this blush. I think I'm gonna go with this one. It's called Popular. Just give me a little bit more. But he was on, and he's introduced, he did say that that was sold out. They were not selling it. I think he said he would have it back in October. And it's something that I will definitely order again. I don't use facial oils every single day, but I do, when I want one, I want one. And I really do like that. But he introduced yesterday a new mask in that Divine Elixir. And it was in a pot about that big around. And it looked wonderful. It's real thick, and it looks like honey. And you put just a little bit on your face and you rub it and it lathers up. And then you can leave it for 30 minutes, I think he said, or you can leave it really as long as you want to leave it. And then you wash it off. And he even suggested, if you have the divine elixir oil, to put it on first and then put that on top of it. So needless to say, I not only ordered one, but I ordered two of those. He was only able to bring a really small number, he said, of that mask. But it's the second product in that Divine Elixir line. So I ordered two so that I would have a backup. You know, and listen, I send things back to the shopping channels all the time if I don't like them. But if something is going to be a big seller, I would rather get one and have it as an extra one for my stash. So we'll see on that one. I'll let you know. And there was even delayed shipping on that. I don't think it's even supposed to be shipped until the first week in September. And by the way, this is the Rimmel pencil in Cafe Au Lait. This could very easily be my favorite lip pencil. And where is it? There we go. You've seen this a million times with this particular pencil. It is the Milani, and the color is 09 Pink Frost. Let me wipe that off. I will list everything below in the description box. And that's another question. Someone asked me the other day, you always talk about the description box or the show more. I don't know where to find it. Well, I always watch videos on my computer, on my laptop, always. And I know on my laptop, it appears right under the video. It says show more, and I can click on that. And all of the links that I may put in, the information about the video, will be right there. Now, on your cell phone or your tablet, I don't know. So it may be in the same place, it may not be. So if you watch, or if you know the answer to that question, will you just leave it below? And that way, anyone who doesn't know where to find that information on their cell phone or on their tablet, they can easily find it so that they can find links to everything too. If you would do that, I would appreciate it. If you know, I just don't watch on those devices. Rarely do I watch. So I don't know. But I know where it is on the laptop or on the computer. It's directly under the video, you'll see show more. Some people refer to that as the description box. So you'll hear it both ways. Okay. Well, that's sort of it. I think that's it. I appreciate each and every one of you more than you'll ever know. More than you'll ever know. And again, I just ask that you go out and be kind to someone. Just be kind to someone. It's so important. It's so important. I think we could look at probably our parents and our grandparents, and they would tell you too that they were living in turbulent times in the world. I think many of us also feel like we live in turbulent times in this world. And sometimes I think we feel, I know I do, really frustrated that there's just not anything that I personally can do about it. And I'm not a politician. I'm not an elected official. I'm not in any high-powered, influential jobs. Other than those of you who watch my YouTube channel. So I directly influence people that I come in contact with every day. Those are the people that I can really influence. And the truth is, that's probably where many of you are too. And we wonder, what can we do? And I truly believe that the best thing we can do is try to be kind. Being kind is a choice. It's a choice I have to make every single day. I don't have to make it as much as I used to because it's become habit with me. I without even thinking, smile and speak to strangers. I compliment strangers. I just try to be nice. I try to be kind. If someone cuts me off in traffic, my first instinct, I promise you, is, well, it's just not nice. But I've learned to take a deep breath and not act on that thought pattern. And so far, that's worked for me. And I think it'll work for you too. I think when we're kind to each other, if we're kind to someone who's having a bad day, even though maybe we don't know they're having a bad day, it might change the way they react to other people that day too. So I just think being kind is so important. It's for sure the one thing that we can do every single day that can change or make our little corner of the world a better place to be. So go out and be kind. Just be kind. What, Biscuit?
Don't forget, everybody, my mommy and me, we want everybody to be kind today. Find somebody to be kind to. If you're kind to others, others will be kind right back at you. It'll make you feel so good.
He's back. We'll see you soon. Bye. Love you.